got Boo, good afternoon. You are in Tokyo, one of the key markets for Dassault System, I should say, historically, with a very long presence here. Can you perhaps introduce us to the new sectors where Dassault System is really active? Dassault System is pretty famous for software like CATIA, for modelization, for the car industry or the aircraft industry. Can you please perhaps first tell us what are the new fields for Dassault System?
So as you know very well, Dassault System, we have been engaging in Japan in many different sectors, but we are known pretty much in the manufacturing sector. Now, our vision is that we can use the virtual world to understand better the real world. And that is applicable to many different segments. So what we have seen is that, of course, the manufacturing industry uses the virtual world to create airplanes, to produce cars. But we can use that technology now in order to develop new segments such as infrastructure and cities. Imagine if you can create a virtual city, you can better understand through simulation how society can evolve in those segments. Similarly, the healthcare industry can use the virtual world. Imagine if you can virtualize a human. Now you can test, simulate a new procedure, maybe new medication via biotechnology. So yes, in many segments, our technology can now be applicable and we can utilize what has been developed over the last 30 years of what we've been doing at Dassault System for those different segments.
So there are two sectors, I think, that are very important, for example, for Africa, where you are particularly active, and that is, as you mentioned, infrastructure and education. Maybe you can talk about these two topics?
So, first of all, we understand that these developing countries, fundamentals are how to make sure that healthcare is done well, how we can leverage knowledge that is coming from all over the world in order to leapfrog them into current technology that we have. So yes, healthcare is at the heart of what we want to do in Africa. And we have done some partnership with ADAN, creating what we call Aquila Care, which is the ability to simulate and fabricate a hospital. What was used to take 5 years to do, now can be done in 150 days. So obviously, virtualization is a way to ease the development of what we're doing in emerging countries like Africa and developing countries. So we have a partnership established already with ADAN. We are engaging with more than 20 countries currently in Africa, and we think by this time next year, we're going to have operational hospital that will be available and will be sustainable. They will be there for the next 20 years with the latest technology, latest information needed to operate them. So that's one factor that is obviously at the heart of what we do. And the second one is something that we have done for quite some time, is investing in workforce of the future. So as we know, in Africa, we have a very large population of students that are being prepared for their needs. And manufacturing industry is one aspect, but obviously healthcare, education is another one. So we have engaged with many, many different countries, many different key institutions, providing over 160,000 solid work licenses. And we're teaching them how to design, but also how to manufacture via 3D printing solution, so that not only these now students are with the latest technology and latest usage all over the world, but also they can utilize this technology for local needs, fabrication of parts locally, don't rely on a supplier or other country to provide parts. So it has an influence on the community itself and how you know, these students can really have a role right away coming out of school.
now we are in, we are perhaps coming out of COVID-19. Of course, this crisis has forced a lot of people to do teleworking and to enter more fast in a virtualized world. How has it affected the popularity of your products, the curiosity towards the Dassault Systèmes solutions?
Obviously, digitalization is understood that is needed for collaboration, for design, product design. So yes, we are at the heart of the concern of many of our customers, how they prepare themselves for the future. So many discussions, many projects are being planned, especially in Japan. Digitalization is a key of transformation vector that the country is currently focusing on. So yes, we are really involved in, and we are seeing that projects are accelerated. Now, the question is the adoption of these changes that are always very difficult to get through. And this is what we are organizing ourselves with the right partner network, right people to help how these changes can happen. In Japan, obviously I'm focused on the Japanese market today, but it's the same all over the world, what we're seeing.
Philippe Godbout, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.